Hey, we are here at Infocom, obviously, as you're watching all these videos, and we are here at the Midas booth with Richard Faraday from Midas, and we looked at the new Midas console. It's small, it's compact, and it's called the Pro One, and I'm going to give it to Richard and have him tell you a little bit about it.
Thank you very much, sir. Welcome, everybody, to Infocom. Welcome to the Midas booth, and welcome to the new Midas Pro One digital mixing console. As you can see, it is a very compact mixer. However, this is a 48-channel mixing console. Very small form factor, very lightweight. It's an all-aluminum. I'll use the word aluminum and not aluminium. It's an all-aluminum frame, so it's very light, very easy to cart around, very portable. Just let me move that a second so we can see a little bit more of the surface. So 16 faders, which can all be input faders, so you can have 16 faders on the surface. But the default state of the console is to have 8 input faders and 8 VCA faders. Now, we use the same way of navigation on the Pro One as we do on the larger Pro Series consoles, so it's very easy to access the channel that you need to get to simply using the VCA and the population groups to get to the channel that you need. For example, if I need to do something to one of the keyboard channels, instead of having to think in terms of what input of the keyboard's in, what layer of fader is that on, all I need to do is select the keyboard VCA and the console immediately presents me with all of the keyboard channels. The drum channels, the guitar channels, the vocal channels, my effects returns. So it's instant access to any channel that you need to get to on the console. Over here we have a daylight visible TFT screen. So this screen is visible even in direct sunlight. So if we take the console outdoors on this wonderful sunny Las Vegas day, you would still be able to see everything displayed on the screen. To the right-hand side of the screen, we've got our channel strip. So we select our channel, we're given the channel overview, we then get to the area of processing we need, and once we're working in this zoomed-in view of our channel strip, the channel strip is then touch-sensitive, so the screen automatically gives us visual support for any control that you're touching. So this is faster than having a touch screen. With a touch screen, you have to touch the screen and then get to the channel strip. This way of working, you just touch the control and the screen automatically gives you visual support. So most of the input channels obviously are somewhere where you can't see them. But because of the VCA and pop-centric navigation, it's very quick to get to the channel that you need instead of thinking in terms of layers or pages of faders. Processing options. We have our MICAM functions, which include swept high and low pass filters, two separate gain controls. You have a remote control for the analog gain on the stage box and a separate digital gain to let you control the gain structure through the console. You have the same multiple compressor plugins that you have on the larger consoles. So 4 different compressor plugins for each input, 5 different compressor plugins for each output, 4 band parametric EQ for the inputs and a 6 band parametric EQ for each one of the 27 mix buses. So although it's a very small console, I can actually run a 24-way monitor mix very easily from the surface using the fader flip function. So if I select any one of my 24 output buses, the console flips so that the faders become the contribution to the selected output. Also on board, we have a rack full of Midas effects plugins, so a choice of 6 different reverb units, 2 different delays, flanger, chorus, phaser, matrix mixer, dynamic EQ, multiband compression. It's all included in the console. We are also the only manufacturer in the world who has Clark Technic graphic EQs on board. So we have more than enough graphic EQs on the console to assign a graphic EQ to each one of our 27 output buses. On the back of the console itself, we have 24 inputs, which all feature Midas mic pres, and 24 analog outputs, so you can get everything in and out of the console really quickly. We also have 3 AES50 ports, which means that the console is compatible with the entire range of Midas digital I/O boxes. So if I want to extend the console beyond the standard 24 inputs, I just connect to one of our I/O boxes and I then have a digital snake connected to the console as well as the inputs which are on the back. The best thing about the whole console is the price. We've never had a Midas digital mixer at this price point before, and the touring package for this console, which includes the flight case, has a retail price of about $11,500. I know it's unbelievable, but that is the truth. And thank you very much for listening.
All right. Well, thank you, Richard. Appreciate that. This is a cool new entry into the market. And if you are a Midas fan, which a lot of people are, you know that Midas sound that we're all really familiar with. This is a majorly affordable way to get into that. And if you thought, well, I really can't get into the Midas digital environment that I want, this is certainly a cool way of doing it. So you can go to, what is Midas's website? Is it just Midas.com?
It's MidasConsoles.com.
MidasConsoles.com. Go and look at it. When is this going to be available?
We will be shipping this. Hopefully these will be available from your local Midas dealer early August.
All right. So there you go. It's a very cool little console, very compact. So you might want to take a look at it.